Dear learners, today we will discuss about the first unit, which is understanding tourism. So this unit, in fact, we have discussed in the previous class as well. So half of the we have discussed, and now we will discuss the remaining part of it. So in the previous class, we have discussed about what is tourism, characteristics of tourism, tourism products and services. We have discussed about the tours and tourism destinations. So in this class, we will discuss about the second part of it, which is forms and types of tourism. So tourism has various forms on the basis of purpose of visit. So if the purpose is leisure, so then there are different forms and types will be there. And if purpose is business, then in business, there are again different forms and types of tourism. And then there are alternative forms. So these we will discuss one by one in the this class only. So these are further divided into many types according to their nature. So forms of tourism emerge from different fields of attention, such as walk, or rest, awake or asleep, exertion or relaxation, income, expenditure, job, family, risk, security. So here I will just give an example. For example, if you are busy in your work throughout the week, so you don't have much time to for yourself to relax, to take rest for some time. So maybe during the weekend you will plan, yes, I want to take rest now, because throughout the week I was really very busy with my work. So maybe in the weekend you will go to the nearby tourist destination just to take the rest, just to relax for some time. So similarly, another example, for example, if some people, they are very busy with their job, so they are not able to give time to the even family because of their work pressure and different other factors. So sometimes if they are getting the long weekend, so they will go out with their family, they will spend some quality time so that they can also give time to their family. Similarly, there are like dirt, noise, rush, pollution and trouble. So these are also the key expressions of such tensions. So the possibility of going away is very important in such context. Similarly, there are many factors why people travel from one place to another place. So the desire for tourism is therefore determined socially. Governments, they promote tourism. People talk about their holidays. So unions, they sponsor holidays. So health insurance, they also covers the visits to spas. Then tax rebates are given for holidays. Then holiday homes and corporations, they reward their employees with travel instead of bonus money, because they also want to promote tourism more and more. And nowadays people are more interested to travel rather than just bonus money as used to get in the past. Then seasonal pressures are, they also strengthen the urge to get away from home. Then we have annual vacations like summer vacation or winter break. So there also there is a movement of people across the country. Then the media, the literature and the fashion, they all strengthen the holiday more. So in India, we still have a transport subsidy called Leave Travel Concession. And most companies, they provide holiday homes for their workers. So whenever people, they get like government employees, they are getting this Leave Travel Concessions, and with this facility, more and more people, they are traveling across the country so that they also get some time with their family. They also spend quality time with their family or friends, and they just want to go out to see the different sightseeings, different landscape, different destinations. So this is again a motivation for people to travel more and more. Then a tourist visit indicates, show something beautiful that is not available at home. Like how people motivated to travel. For example, if in the morning you have seen in the newspaper, okay, typical holiday symbols like the sun, a beach umbrella, a palm fringed coastline. So if you have seen that particular picture of that particular destination in a newspaper, in the TV or some other source. So you really get motivated, yes, whenever we get time or whenever we have holidays, so we will go to that particular destination. So this is how you get motivated. Then show people from other cultures, always beaming happy, friendly, and this is again another motivation or another factor which will motivate you. Yes, we also want to travel, we want to see the culture of different people of that particular destination, how they dress up, what is their eating habits. So all these things again motivate you to travel to a particular destination. Then we will discuss the various types of tourism. So one by one, first is the rest and recuperation. So taking rest from everyday life or recovery from some illness or exertion. So here people spend leisure time. Leisure time means just free time, not doing any work. And relaxation, maybe you just want to sleep or relax or walking on the beach or spend the time whatever way you want, because you have no work pressure. So you are there just to take rest and just to relax yourself, no work, nothing at all. So this is one of the form of the tourism, that is rest and recuperation. Then another type is escape. So escape from everyday reality to an imaginary world of freedom. Why imaginary world of freedom? Because when you are planning to go to a place, especially if it is you are going to that particular destination for the first time, so you will definitely imagine, yes, I'm going there, because you must have seen the pictures on the net, or maybe you have heard about that destination from your friends or relatives. So yes, you are planning, you are imagining about that, yes, I will go there. So there I will go for shopping, I will go for different this adventure activities, whatever is available over there. So you start imagining about that destination. So this is in the tourism, again we say, like in tourism we are just selling dreams, and the challenge is to convert dreams into reality. So once you are planning to go to a particular destination, means you are escaping from everyday reality to an imaginary world of freedom. So there you will have no work, no pressure, nothing. You are just there, going there to get a freedom. You just want to relax over there, so you just want to get a quality time over there. So this is how the second type is escape. Then we have another third type. So then the third type of tourism, that is communication. So communication, like spending quality time with family and friends, or make new friends who is not a close friend of you. Why we say quality time? Because nowadays we have seen that like most of the people, they are really busy their work, and especially nowadays we have seen the nuclear families are there, and both the parents are working, and with working parents sometimes like they are going in the morning, coming in the evening, and they sometimes they hardly get time to even spend with each other or to communicate with each other, because the schedules are so tight, and if the, you have to spend the time for the children also. Children are also going to the school or maybe colleges, and parents are working. So you will not get the quality time in your day-to-day life. So sometimes people, whenever they go out to some destination, or maybe if they have long weekend or they have some holidays, so there they also get time to spend quality time with each other, to communicate more and more, which you are not getting maybe in your day-to-day life because of this very busy schedules nowadays. So that's why another type is communication, so that people, when they are going out, they are getting quality time to spend with their family or their friends, which they are not getting maybe in the day-to-day routine. So then we have another type, that is culture and education. And this is very much important type. Why? I will just explain. Is because culture tourism satisfies the cultural and intellectual curiosity and involves visit to ancient monuments, places of historical or religious importance, and their culture. The culture is most important factor which attracts tourists to a destination. And cultural tourism give insight to way of life of the people of distant land, their dresses, jewelry, dance, music, architecture, then their customs and traditions, then fairs and festivals, their religions, their culinary delights, the freedom, etc. So culture and education, this is also one of the very important factors which motivates the people to travel to different places, because whenever we go to a tourist destination, so we are always interested to know about the culture of people of that particular destination. So what is their dressing sense, what are these customs they follow, what is their this thing, traditions, what are their fairs and festivals, which religion they are following, what are their eating habits, what is the local famous food of that particular area. So all this comes under the culture. So people are really interested to know about all these factors. So this is why the culture and education is also very much this one of the motivating factor of people to travel to different places. So then we have another type, that is freedom. So tourism frees you from home and work and is directed towards facilities and comforts rather than experience. So why freedom? Because whenever you are in your this routine life, we are in the your workplace or in your home, so you have different things to do. Whenever you want to get some free time also, but still you have different assignments, you have the different things you have to do, so you hardly get some time. But once you are away from your routine, like maybe your workplace, your home, so whenever you're spending time in your holidays or in some tourist destination, so there you are getting really full freedom, because no work, nothing, you are there just to get some quality time, just to relax, just to get the things of that particular area, to know about new things, to know about different places. So you are getting total freedom from your routine things, which is your work or which is your other routine things. So next important type of tourism, that is health tourism. So people have been traveling two centuries to improve and rebuild their health and stamina. So today, many people travel great distances to exotic locations or healthcare facilities in other countries. So why? In search of medical treatment and cure. So visit to spas, undergo cures for chronic ailment, then visit health clubs for workouts or do yoga. So these all are the factors why so people travel for health. So many developing countries are emerging as hot medical tourism destinations. So thus, health tourism covers the following aspects, like change of climate, then alternative therapy, for example, Ayurvedic treatment, then hot sulfur springs, then we have naturopathy and art of living. So these are also few factors for which people travel from one places to another places. And then some people, they also go for the medical treatment. For example, in some countries, some medical treatment is very expensive, and they will go to the, some other country where the it's less expensive. So that is also one of the this factor of traveling from one place to another place. So another type is the special interest tours. So special interest tours is organized as per the special interests of the tourist, ranging from medical, historical, archaeological, and other interests to golf or it can be fishing. So for example, visits of tourists to a historical monument. So these type of tourists, those who have really interest about in the monuments, so they just want to know about each and everything about that particular monument, their history, their background, their design of the architecture, etc. For example, people, those who are interested in the monuments, they may visit Agra to see the Taj Mahal. So they just want to know about the history of it, who has built the Taj Mahal, design of their architecture, and each and everything about that particular monument. Then we have another type of tourism, that is adventure and wildlife. So far away from the modern civilization, with the porters and mules, a camel or elephants, or in the jeeps, so mixing trekking and hiking and camp life with the luxury of first-class hotel. So in this category, adventure and wildlife, so tourists, those who are really interested in the different adventure activities, or those who are interested in the wildlife, so they will go to different places. So they just want to get the real feel of that particular destination. They will experience the different adventure activities offered in that particular destinations. So adventure tourism is a tour designed around an adventurous activity such as rafting, it can be hiking or mountain climbing. This type of tourists are interested in purely experiencing the real adventure of that particular destination. Or other, those who are interested in the wildlife, they are interested to go to the wildlife sanctuaries. They want to see this wild animals in their natural habitat. So what is their behavior, what are their eating habits, and want to know more and more about this wildlife. Then another type of tourism, that is the convention tourism. So to mix leisure with work, they are holding conventions or meetings at the tourist destinations. So then we have tourists visit a particular destination for various reasons pertaining to his or her work, such as attending a business meeting, conferences, conventions, selling some products, meeting clients. So these all come under the category of the convention tourism. So business tourism is popularly called as MICE tourism. Like in MICE means meetings, incentives, conferences and exhibitions. So this convention tourism is becoming famous day by day, because whenever people, they are organizing some meetings, so they choose some tourist destination so that people go there to attend the meeting or some any business related purpose. So in the, at the end of the day, they can go to the nearby destination, they can go for the sightseeing, or they can maybe next day if they are free, so they will explore the, that particular area, so that it is mixed with the business as well as leisure. So this is another upcoming form of tourism. So then there are different form of tourism also give rise to different types of tourists. For example, a ridiculous tourist who is dressed in funny clothes and view everything through the lens of a camera. As nowadays you have seen people, they are so busy in taking their selfie whenever they are going to any destination. If they are traveling from a different type of mode, maybe if they are traveling in the rickshaws or not, other than the routine mode of travels, or they are in the beach or wherever they are, if whatever see the new, well, they start taking this selfie with that particular things, even if it is not relevant. So that trend you have seen is everywhere nowadays. Then the another type of tourist, it's the naive tourist who is inexperienced in travel and always asks unnecessary questions and has no language skill. So this is another type of tourist. Then the organized tourist who feels at home with guide and a group of fellow tourists. So these tourists, they organize, why? Because they plan their things in advance. They will contact the guide, or maybe they are traveling with their friends within a package tour. So they plan everything in advance and they are in a safe mode as compared to other, because they have their guide facility with them who will explain them about that destination. So this is other type of tourist rather than unplanned tourist. Then we have ugly tourist who behaves as if he owns the world. Then we have another type of tourist, that is the uncultured tourist who spends his time just lazing and eating, doing nothing else. Then there is another type of tourist, that is the rich tourist who can afford anything and likes to show prosperity and enjoys being waited upon. Then other type is the exploiting tourist who spends a holiday at the cost of people and takes the advantages of their culture, their hospitality and sometimes their poverty also. Okay, the other type of tourist is the polluting tourist who demands that for his comfort everything can be destroyed. Then other type of tourist is the alternative tourist who explores the few untouched corners of the world and thus opening the ways to mass tourism. This alternative tourism, this is also another important type of tourism, because these type of tourists, they just don't want to go to the regular destination or where more you just see the crowd and all the tourists are going to that places which is very famous from so many years. So they just want to divert from that routine to some alternative places. So they will go to some alternative destinations which is untouched, unexplored destination. So this is how they are opening the ways to the mass tourism. Why? Because today if they are going, so tomorrow they may inform to their friends through word of mouth publicity. Other people will also come to know about that new destination. Yes, it is less explored. It is just that destination is still fragile destination. So people may start going, may other people will also follow. They will also start going to that particular destination. So this is how slowly and slowly that destination may also get the mass tourism. So this was all about the different types of. So first we have discussed about the different types of tourism and different types of tourists as well. So now with this we have covered the various types of tourism. So now we will discuss about the future trends of tourism. So there was a time when tourism was promoted because of its economic benefits, because a transfer of wealth from rich to poor was possible. The regional imbalances could be overcome in the areas where there was no other developmental resources. So provide employment to people with low educational or skill levels. So here I will give an example, because in the tourism, as you know, there are different categories, there are different levels of job opportunities. So people with low education or low skill level, even they can be accommodated in the lower levels of the job, like attender, like this waiter or porter. So they can also get the employment opportunities at the lower level. So that was also one of the reasons to promote tourism in the past. Then another important factor was give rise to economic growth with the circulation of the tourist dollar. So these were the few important factors why this mass tourism was promoted in the past. But now, after 4 decades of organized mass tourism, today the option for the future is sustainable tourism, a tourism controlled by the local people at their pace and in answer to their needs. Like, why local people? Because whenever we are just establishing or we are developing any destination as a tourism destination, so the local people of that particular area, they should also get benefit out of the tourism. They should get the job opportunities. They should also earn the benefit coming out from the tourism. It should not be like the only the big companies, all multinational companies or all big brand hotels, they are set up in that particular destination, and the top level employees, they are also, because they also need the experienced people, because they want to just maintain the name of their brand. So they will just hire the people from the outside or maybe from some metro cities. So many times we have seen that local people, they are ignored. If they will get the job, they will just get the jobs at the lower levels only. So these people should also get benefit out of it. It should not be like only multinational companies are set up over there, big brand hotels are there, and the main income or benefit out of tourism, they are just going to that people only. Whereas that land or that particular destination, it belongs to local people. So these local people should also get benefits out of tourism. They should get the job opportunities. If they are not that level skilled or that trained, so they should also give the opportunity to improve their skills, to get some training, so that they will also get good jobs in that particular hotels or some other companies or whatever things related to tourism. So ultimate benefit should also go to the local people. So the essential aspect of sustainable tourism is the concept of the carrying capacity, that is a control on the number of tourists as well as the type of tourism to be developed. So carrying capacity is a concept that has to be kept in the mind, the needs of the environment, the level of development, both economic and social, then the culture, then the population and its need in the present and in the future. Why present in the future? I will just add an example, because it's not like whatever at present we are enjoying. Like if we are going to some tourist destination, so we enjoy the scenic beauty of that particular area, we see the different landscape, we see the green forest, so whatever natural beauty, natural resources are there, which we really get enjoy whenever we go to tourist destination. So these resources, this natural scenic beauty, these all should be maintained for the future generation as well, because after few years, whatever our new generation is there, they should also get the benefit of these things. So we should conserve, we should preserve, we should not over exploit our resources, so that future generation, they will also get some of the greenery, some natural resources to see. So it is very important to understand the concept of sustainable tourism, the carrying capacity. We should only send that particular number of tourists to a destination which can be easily accommodated over there, so that we should not promote the mass tourism. Nowadays, we should see about all these are very important factors, so that our future generation, our next generation, they will also have something, all these natural resources or whatever natural scenery, whatever natural beauty, different landscape, so they should be conserved, they should be preserved, so that our next generation, future generation, they will also get benefit out of it. Then we have tourism versus other forms of economic activity. So that also we have to keep in the mind. So with this, So in today's class, we have discussed about the various forms and types of tourism. In forms and types, I have discussed all the types of tourism. One by one, we have explained each and every type. Then we have discussed about the different types of tourists. And after that, we have discussed about the future trends of tourism. Like what are the future trends? Nowadays, as I've explained, like people are more concerned about new concepts like sustainable tourism, responsible tourism, carrying capacity. So all these also have very important role in promoting tourism in the future. So with this, we will conclude today's class. Thank you.